Welcome back. In this step, we would look at another Eclipse feature called Save Actions. If you are like me, then you would be very lazy. For lazy people like us, we would need Eclipse to do a lot more things. One of the things that Eclipse can do automatically for us is do something like formatting. So you have this piece of code right now, so this is not really well formatted, right? So map.put is on the same line. Typically, how you can do the formatting is by pressing Ctrl-Shift-F. So if you press Ctrl-Shift-F or Command-Shift-F, then the code gets automatically formatted. If you want to organize the imports, I mean, you can see that there's an unused import in here. So we have another shortcut, Ctrl-Shift-O. So it would organize the imports. It would remove unused imports and things like that. However, I don't want to keep pressing these shortcuts again and again. Every time I do a save, I would want these to happen automatically. How do I do that? That's through save action. So I'm doing a Control Z to undo the formatting and the organize imports. And now class is back to the old state, unclean states. And what I would do now is go to Eclipse, preferences. If you're in Windows, you already know that. It's window preferences. And type in save. You can see now there is something called save actions. So save actions are things which are performed on saving a file. So I would say perform the selected save actions. For now, I would want to format source code. You can actually choose between format all lines or format edited lines. If you are in a big project, I would recommend you to use format edited lines because you don't want to format all the other code which is present in there. You'd only want to format the code which you are writing. You can actually configure how you'd want to format in here in the formatter page. The other thing I'm adding in is organize imports. So for now, let's focus on format source code and organize imports. And I click apply and click OK. Cool. Now I'm doing a save, Control S. Nothing happened. So now I press and enter and do a save. You'd see that everything happens automatically. You can see that the code is formatted, the imports disappeared. So let's do a Control Z. So now this is where the code is. In the current state, you have an unorganized, like you have an unused import, you have unformatted code, and all that I do is save. So I'm doing enter and save. And that's it. You can see that the code is again in a formatted state. So organized imports is happening automatically. You can see that formatting of code is happening automatically. This is called save actions. You can actually do a lot more in save actions. So if I go to save actions, you can actually now choose other additional actions as well. So you can actually add in things like you can remove unnecessary cache, you can add annotations like at override annotations and things like that. If you don't really know them, that's not a problem. We will learn them in subsequent steps. You can click configure and you can actually configure other stuff as well. So you can actually sort your members. So you would want, if you want to sort your member variables in a specific way, you can sort them. If you actually want to convert for loops to enhanced, or if you want to always use blocks, blocks are this, right? So if you always, so even if there's a single line if statement, you'd want to use a block, you can enable this. So all that you need to do is type the simple if statement with one line, and then it would add blocks around it. And it would also do other things around variables. So you can add a final. You can actually add how do you want to access the member variables. You can add at override and at deprecated things. And you can also remove unused code. So you can remove unused imports, remove unused private members. You can even remove unused local variables. So all this kind of stuff you can configure in the save actions. You can actually play around with them and try to figure out which ones work best for you. But for me, at a minimum, I would actually use formatting source code and organize imports as part of my save actions. That's all you'd need to know about save actions. Save actions is a simple thing, but it saves you a lot of time. It keeps my code formatted always, and all my imports are always organized. Until next step, bye-bye.